The story can be told in so many different ways. A young couple on their honeymoon, they do something different. They go to South Africa for a safari. And of course, it's beautiful. And the groom, he wants to take many pictures, but warned, stay close to the jeeps. Stay close to the jeeps. Well, he's got his telescopic lens, and he's taking these pictures of the lions, but sure enough, one of the lions catches sight of him and comes running after him, but he was in such a position, he couldn't get back to the jeeps. And so he's running and running and running, the lion's coming close, and finally, he falls into a ravine, but he's able, what, to grab one of the trees, a branch, and he's screaming and screaming, God, help me, please. Okay, my brother, let go. I will catch you. And what's the response? Is anybody else up there? Help me! How many times do we cry to God for help? I know as a young boy, I would beg God for help. And it seemed like nothing was happening. Begging God for my mother who was very sick. Begging, negotiating. I'll do whatever you want, just take care of my mom. Have you ever done that? Where you do sort of negotiating, maybe like a peace treaty, as if I was negotiating with God, as if God was an equal with me. And we hear that in the gospel, where Jesus says, remember, you are merely servants. You're not the one who comes in and sits down waiting to be waited on. You are a servant. We are servants to God. But oftentimes we see ourselves as equals and on occasion, greater than God. Lord, in my prayer, I expect this, this, and this. I expect this. And if you don't do this, I'm finished with you. And God's sort of, I think, amazed at that. In Habakkuk, our first reading, Habakkuk screams out to God, Lord, there's violence all around me. Would you please step in and do something? Don't you hear my prayer? And the Lord says, Habakkuk, hello. Yes, there's violence all around you, but the days are short. Just give it some time, and you will even see the vision unfold. You will witness the vision yourself. Not your children, your grandchildren. You will witness my glory. But don't be so demanding. And you expect it so fast, good prophet. The disciples begged the Lord, Lord, give us faith. Give us more faith. Jesus is like, what do you mean? Give you more faith. It's not a commodity. It's not a couple barrels of oil or stacks of coffee. It's not a commodity to be bought or sold. Jesus said, you have faith. You have it in you. Use it. What is it what do they say? If we don't use our muscles, I'm lifting my legs. If we don't use our muscles, what? If we don't use them, we lose them. Exactly. I have muscle. Believe me, under these vestments, it's not all fat. So we have to use our muscles or we lose them. Use your faith or lose it. Use your faith. Well, what does that mean, use it? Up here up the road at the Presbyterian Church, I love some of their signs and their marquee. And one was, faith is praying for rain. Excuse me, prayer is praying for rain. Faith is what? Bring the umbrella. Yes? I've done that a few times. All you have to do is wash your car. Yes? It's like, you know, so you wash your car, and it's like, where did that come from? 10% chance of rain. It never rains when it's 80%. When it's 10%, it's like, there's no way it's going to rain, and it rains just on us. Like, really, Lord? How does this work out? It's sort of strange what's occurring in the Caribbean Sea. You know, this super huge, super powerful hurricane. And for all the information and science we have around it, we know a lot about it. There's one thing we can't do, and that's control it. And it's rather upsetting that it's going to make its way north. There's not many options. It's not going to go east. It can't go south to the equator. That's an impossibility, the way the planet spins. So it's either going to go north, a little northwest, doubt it, and it's going to hit either Haiti or Jamaica. You know, it's one thing to hit the United States. We have insurance. We have so many opportunities to kind of get ourselves out of trouble with relief from the government or the church. But in some of these poor countries, homes not made like our homes. The people will beg God, spare us as the storm gets closer and closer. And chances are it's not going to make a sharp right or a sharp left. It's going to make its way north. And people are going to suffer and people are going to die. Now, our prayer is not, Lord, spare us, but that means they have to get the hurricane. No. Our prayer is, Lord, spare all those who will suffer from the storm. People are going to suffer. And we don't know if it's not ourselves yet either. Lord, be with those who will suffer. I bet you God in heaven sometimes says to the angels, I wish I had never created weather on the planet Earth. Because all I get is, Lord, send us rain. Lord, you're giving us too much rain. Lord, would you dry the fields? Lord, the fields have no water. On and on, the Lord is hearing prayers of rain and weather. It's like, enough already. I am with you. Use your faith. Use it. Again, hear the Lord. Use your faith. And trust me. Well, Lord, how do you want me to use your faith? I go to church. Yes, you go to church, and even you give a tithe. Very good. Now do more. Well, what's that like? How's this? Maybe St. Vincent de Paul. Add two more zeros to the check you wrote. Oh, no, you don't. I need that. Yes, you need that like the young groom holding on to the branch. Who is really protecting you? Who's protecting you? The branch you hang from, and really, we're all hanging from the branch. We don't see it. But we're all hanging from the branch. And it's like, is there anybody else out there? That's what we cry out. Because we can't imagine God always catching us. If we suffer the slightest bit, or there's any disappointment, people are through with God. Not because they don't have faith, but because they have not put that faith into action. In other words, the Lord says, go forth. Go forth. And see, I know what God expects of me. I know full well. You get in situations where, I get in situations where I do not want to forgive, that I want to hold a grudge, that I want to really browbeat someone like, look how bad you are. And the Lord says, that's what you want. Now, do you want to do what you want or do what I want? I want to do what I want, Lord. That's not putting faith into action. I have to do, and I know what God wants of me, and you know. It's not like, Father, I come to church tomorrow. What does God want of me? You know what God wants of you. And what is our response to God? Okay, ask me something else. You've asked me to do this. I don't want to do it. I refuse to do it. So ask me something else. You know what God wants of you. You know what God wants, and I do too. So the thing is, well, Lord, I want to put it into action, but I'm weak. I'm not disciplined. Okay, all right, the Lord says. Start with small matters. Forgive in small ways. Be generous in small ways. And keep pushing yourself a little more and a little more. That's putting your faith into action. But don't let your muscles go to waste. Don't stop at a certain point in one's spiritual life. I've accomplished what I want, And to be so presumptuous, my destiny is heaven. What do I have to worry about? Let us not presume God's goodness. God is good, and God is very merciful. But let us not presume that. Let us put our trust and confidence in the Lord and say, Lord, I have faith. It's very small, but I have faith. Lord, I'm going to put that into so much work because I want to see my faith grow even more. I want to see my relationship with you grow stronger and stronger as I get older.